I just, Father, give me the words to talk to my sisters and my brothers. Okay, so I'm going to talk about abortion. And this is not to browbeat you. This isn't to guilt you or to cause shame, all right? I download podcasts from different Christian shows, and I listen to them throughout the day. And heard another show today where a lady had a testimony where she had an abortion. And subsequently, you know, when she got married later on in life and she wanted to start her family, subsequently she had miscarriages. And even when she finally was able to give birth, the child was underweight and complications. It just breaks my heart. But I've discussed this issue before, abortion and the generational curse that it happens afterwards. And again, please listen to me. I'm not trying to shame you. This isn't the point of the video. I'm pleading with you. I really want to be a brother to you, okay? I am your friend, all right? I'm not trying to shame you at all. I've mentioned this stuff before in my other videos, but I just want to do a video strictly on this subject because it needs to go everywhere. We need to tell our brothers and sisters and other Christians that this is what is happening, okay? Roe v. Wade was 39 years ago. 39. So this is already starting to affect our grandchildren, all right? So listen to me very carefully. There are some curses, okay? If you have an abortion, there are curses. All right, and part of that curse is a demon called Molech, all right? It's all throughout the Old Testament. Here are the variations of the spelling if you want to look it up. Molech, okay? I'm not going to get too deep into it. I just want to let you know that every time when I'm doing a deliverance on somebody, and these are Christians, okay? These are Christians. When you accepted Jesus Christ, you automatically did not get delivered, okay? Maybe some of you did, but that is not the norm, all right? You have to confess these sins and cast them out, all right? So when you had an abortion, and when I do deliverances, if I hear that somebody has an abortion, 10 times out of 10 times, they have the demon Molech, all right? And I need to put this in perspective for you, because a lot of people do the same sins, you know, unforgiveness, lust, envy, stealing, whatever. I rarely come across the same demon over and over and over again, okay? But if there is an abortion, I always come across the demon Molech. I always do. I don't know if Molech is a high prince over America or is just straight up the first lieutenant in Lucifer's army. I don't know. But he is prevalent. Okay? And any demon that is in your lineage, if you have any blood, okay, from someone in your lineage who has had an abortion, 98% sure that you have Molech, even if you didn't commit an abortion. And this goes for the guys too. If you caused your girlfriend, your ex-girlfriend, wife, whoever, if you caused another woman to have an abortion, you can have it as well. And when you have sex with your spouse, you become one flesh and you can pass that demon onto your spouse. So please, guys, I am angry at the devil, but I'm angry too that this does not get out. That when you have an abortion, the church teaches us that just repent and everything's good. And that's not the case, guys. The abortion did not cause you to have 3-4 miscarriages afterwards. It wasn't the procedure. It is a demon. And that demon is a very, very powerful demon, okay, that wants to destroy your children. It also talks about in the Ammonites. This is the Ammonites god in the Old Testament. And there were some sexual orgies also along with the child sacrifice. So if you had an abortion and then you went sexually, you know, you're very sexual promiscuous afterwards too, then that is another sign that you have the demon Molech. Molech comes through miscarriages, if you have female issues, if you can't, if you're barren. So, you know, don't spend 10 plus grand on the, you know, on the fertilization treatments. Don't do it. If you're a Christian, Jesus Christ has the power. You've been given the authority to cast out devils, okay? This abortion is one of the most shameful things that people go through, okay? And what's shame? Shame is not conviction from the Holy Spirit. Shame is a demonic influence. Shame causes you to keep the secret in the dark, okay? And we fight against the powers of the darkness, all right? When we come to God, we, you know, it says the unrighteous hate the light because their evil deeds will be exposed. If you want to be free, you may have to confess these sins to one another. If they're affecting your family, if you have not gotten rid of Molech and you've had children, then they have Molech. Okay, and like I said, Roe v. Wade was 39 years ago. So if your grandchildren are now having female issues, barrenness, miscarriages, okay, the demon Molech has been passed down to them. They need to be free, okay? Repentance is not enough. Repentance takes away the legal right of the demon, but it has to be cast out, okay? And some demons, you know, you have to rely on the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, how can I get rid of this demon Molech? And if the Holy Spirit tells you, you know, you had this abortion in secret and the dad, who you haven't talked to in 30 years, never knew that his child was murdered, the Holy Spirit may have you call that person and confess it to them. This is tough stuff, guys. This is tough stuff. I don't want to shame you, but you have to bring this out into the light. It can't be the family secret any longer. You know what you do? The family secret is fuel for the devil, and he loves it. He wants you to be afraid of it. He wants you to be shameful for it because he has the power in the darkness. And he keeps on killing the kids. He keeps on killing the kids. He keeps on killing the kids. This demon has the power to mess with your physical body. You guys need to get this, okay? So I'm tired of listening to Christian radio hosts who hear these testimonies and they're like, you know, well, praise Jesus that God used it, you know, use this event in your life to become a stronger Christian. Yeah, praise Jesus for that. But you need to cast out that devil, okay? Please, we cannot toy with this any longer. Generational curses, they're real. They are real, okay? Deuteronomy 5:9, the iniquities of the fathers to the third and fourth generation. If there's incest or a child out of wedlock, that is 10 generations. Deuteronomy 23:2. Okay, well, God is unfair. God, how can God do this? Well, God says, if you love me, it's to 1,000 generations. Deuteronomy 7:9. All right, in Amos 5:26 and 27, it says, you know, because you've sacrificed to Molech, one of the curses is I'll put you into captivity beyond Damascus. And I looked up that word, what Damascus means, and it's kind of hard to find, but one source says it's Strong's Concordance, and I have a Strong's Concordance and didn't say it in the book, but on the website it says, silent is the sackcloth weaver. Silent is the sackcloth weaver. Sackcloth is what you wear when you mourn. So, and then silent is this shame that this abortion is in. So it's just kind of an interesting curse. It really matches to what we're talking about. Silent is the sackcloth weaver. And then in Acts 7:43, it talks about, you know, the captivity will go beyond Babylon this time instead of Damascus. I don't know why there's a difference, but Babylon means confusion from Babel. So maybe another curse you get along with this is confusion. Needless to say, guys, I know you repented. If you are a sister or a brother whose heart is after God, I know you repented probably a billion times. I get it. But you need to ask the Holy Spirit. You know, don't take my word for it. Ask the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit wants his temple free more than you want it free. Okay. So Holy Spirit, do I need to be delivered? Show me. Do I need to be delivered? Okay. You confess a sin. And if the Holy Spirit tells you, you have to confess this, especially if you pass it down to your kids. You got to confess the sin, guys. Confess your faults to one to another. Pray for each other that you may be healed. All right? This is a tough subject, guys. This is a tough subject. If you need help, if you're in the California area, I would love to help you. There's other deliverance ministers around the country. But please, we got to take care of this demon. Repentance is not enough. Okay, repentance is not enough. It has to be cast out. There's so many, you know, the majority of the demons that I deal with, their legal rights have already been taken care of. They are there illegally for decades sometimes. For decades, the demons are there illegally. The way they got into the Christian was taken care of a long time ago. But because nobody cast them out, they were squatters and they still wrecked havoc in those Christians' lives because nobody taught them that Christians can have demons. All right, please spread this information, guys. I'm tired of hearing stories and testimonies of Christian women who have an abortion. They repent, but yet they suffer years and years and years of miscarriages, of spotting, of uterine cancer, cervical cancer, barrenness. Stop. This has to stop. We need to bring this crappy sin into the light so it can be exposed and God can heal it and God can save the family. Okay, if you have passed this on to your kids, if the kids are not of the age of accountability, you yourself, the man and woman, have authority over that child. You can cast it out yourself. Okay, Mark 9, when the boy comes to Jesus and the demon starts seizing the kid, Jesus talks to the dad. Okay, go read that story, Mark 9. Do you have faith, Dad? Do you have faith that I can do this? Lord, help my unbelief. Okay. Perfect generational curse example of how we take care of these demons. All right. I love you guys. Please, I'm not here to shame you, but you have to spread this information. You have to spread this information to Christians, to brothers. You got to confess this stuff, and you have to cast out Molech. I'm tired of him destroying the children. Please. I love you. God bless you.